Next in the ring, we have lot 8-5 from Brooke Roach of Edam. The Red Angus Simmental Cross Heifers exposed to Black Angus Bulls from June 6th to July 23rd. Average weight, 1168. Next in the ring, we have lot 8-6 from John Roach of Edam. Simmental Red Angus Cross Heifers exposed Black Angus Bulls from June 6th to July 23rd. Average weight, 1167. Next in the ring, ladies and gentlemen, lot 8-7 from Joey LeClaire of Edam. The Black Angus Cross Heifers exposed Black Angus Bulls from June 10th to August 30th. Average weight, 1,086 pounds. Now coming into the ring, lot 8-8 from Dusty Creek Ranch, Don Cole of Edam. The Red Angus Simmental Cross Heifers exposed to Red and Black Angus Bulls from June 15th to September 1st. Average weight, 1171. If I could get a hold of James Monteith. James Monteith, if you could please come to the show ring. The sponsor for this class, ladies and gentlemen, grand champion sponsor is Gary's Construction. Reserve champion is Lavaster Sales and Service.
Well, this is our last class for me to look at today. I'm sure would like to thank the Edam Fall Committee that asked me to judge here today. It was a great honor and a pleasure. I knew it was going to be an easy thing for me to do because it's good cattle to look at. It's pretty easy for somebody to pick through cattle that look like these. I know the cattlemen around here, purebred and commercial guys, that it's probably the strongest area around, and I know what kind of caliber of bulls are bought to create these kind of females, and I'm not just saying the ones in the ring, but the works that behind some of the ones I sent back. I love the females. There might be one in the pen that doesn't fit, not saying she isn't good enough, but maybe doesn't fit the pen. So it is a group class, and so we started with this pen here. They come in last in the order, but boy, they really do jump at you when they come in. That's a pretty classy pen of heifers that really fit together, complement one another. I think can do a ranch or a breeder a lot of good when they get these females home. I think heifers that's got a lot of future in them.
Four, yeah.
And we get into another group of red brockle face heifers here, heifers that sure are uniform, fit together nice. They're soft bodied. They look like females with good cow heads on them, that they got some future in these females here. Heifers that I think are going to be pretty easy doing kind of females. Heifers that I think have got a great future for their owner here. And he's did a good job of putting these heifers together, and I'm pretty sure if they were all bred to the same bull, you're going to have some good coupons coming out of these females.
One.
Let me get into the Samantal females here. Another group that come in right off the bat in the sale or the show order, and females that you gotta really like. They got lots of performance in them, yet they're soft made. They're not coarse made. They're nice through the front ends. They look like females should look. They got good cow heads on them. They got soft sided and carry themselves real well. A nice group of females. A little bigger if you're looking for a little more frame to them, but still just very, very nice females.
Four. Eight, six, yeah.
And we get into our fourth place heifers here. Again, red blaze brockle face heifers that really fit together nice. Females that follow the pattern of our top three groups here, very uniform. The fellow that's brought them out has picked and selected females that I think will really go out and work. They're nice feminine front-ended females, good heads on them, lots of volume to them, not carrying a lot of condition. Females that I think that's going to have some future. Once again, I'd certainly like to thank everybody. It was enjoyable to do the show today, and I really think the exhibitors, they're the ones that do the work before this, and they certainly deserve a round of applause because they've done a really good job at presenting these cattle, and it's a lot of work, and I think there's some rewards in this when you can bring females out like this. It's going to be fun.
Ladies and gentlemen, I'd like to take this time to thank Mr. Mick Trefiak for judging our show. If we could give him a round of applause, and thank you very much. Ladies and gentlemen, the class winners of the Pen of Five Breds at Lot 8-8 from Dusty Creek Ranch, Don Cole. Reserve champions go to lot 8-4 from Craig Ranching, Gordy Craig. Third place, lot 8-1 from Doug Marjoram of Spears. And fourth place, lot 8-6, John Roach of Edam. I'd like to take this time to just call James Monteith into the ring.
Good. Annually, the Edam Fall Fair gives out a $1,000 scholarship for any 4-H beef member in the province of Saskatchewan. We changed it up a little bit this year to join the digital age. And so we set it out to Sask 4-H.